Your Excellencies, Mr. Devan, dear representatives from the diplomatic corps, dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, I would say if we would have an Albanian zodiac, beyond any doubt, November would have been the month of the awareness and the strength, perhaps under the sign of a black eagle. It has happened that in November have occurred several historically significant events for my nation. But the culmination was the proclamation of the independence in November 1912. It came after a very long period of time, almost five centuries, which challenged even our identity. Exactly 100 years ago, we proclaimed the independence and started to build our state. It went through difficult labyrinths of the two world wars and a dictatorship. The dictatorship took in time the half of the independence period until the Berliner Wall fell down. It is very interesting to mention fact to mention that the wall in the German capital presented morally at the same time the bunker where the Albanians isolated themselves during this dictatorship. In the last two decades, the country is heading in the right political direction, building democratic institutions and a free market. The progress is remarkable. Albania, already a NATO member since 2009, aspires to become a member of the EU. The European Commission, in October this year, has recommended candidate status. Who would have dreamed for that to happen some 20 years ago? In this particular jubilee, the Albanians have reasons to celebrate, but more reasons are to commemorate and reflect. There are reasons also to face our own history, a complex one which has imposed now and then the way of dealing with it. But we don't have any more political taboos. We are open to look at the facts as they are used to be and they are. Our historians have started to do it. Welcome and appreciated are also the foreign researchers and scholars who had always given their precious contribution and have also an important role to play. As for the Albanian tradition and language, they are the best testimonies of the strength of the nation to stand through the centuries. With the opening of the country, facing the globalization influences, additional efforts are needed to maintain the tradition. On the other hand, an open debate is going on in the media and among the experts on the standard version of the language, mainly on the proportions of the two main dialects, the Northern Gek and the Southern Tosk, in it. I appreciate very much the fact that in this particular anniversary, this two-day symposium is taking place in Leiden, in this important university center on the Albanian culture, tradition and language. Yesterday was screened the movie with an Albanian theme, The Forgiveness of the Blood, highly estimated by the international critics. Today I am looking forward to the second part of the program with the lectures. Partly I would like to thank Mr. Michiel Devan, who was the initiator of this activity, for his efforts and everything he did to make it happened. The embassy supported gladly this idea from the beginning of the preparation. Special thanks I would like to extend to the University Center of Leiden for the support and the hospitality, and to everybody who was involved, especially Borana Lushe. Special thanks to the speakers Mrs. Darinka Pichani, Mr. Raymond Dutre, professor, Mr. Rule Scout, and Mr. Robert Elsie, for accepting to come and to participate. Their lectures will be enlightening and good food for thought for all of us here in this symposium. Two Albanian artists, Mrs. Adelina Hassani and Mirza Adami, living in the Netherlands, will perform a musical intermezzo. We are proud of them and grateful for their being here with us. On behalf of the embassy, I would like to warmly welcome you all today and wish to you an interesting afternoon. Enjoy the symposium. Thanks.